Hi, everyone. I miss you. Welcome back to our brand new library. This week for our featured story, I actually picked a nonfiction story. So we know that nonfiction means that it's true. And I picked this story because Friday, April 16th is National Librarian Day. So I picked a true story about a librarian who did something pretty incredible. It is written as a picture book, though, so it might look like it's fiction because it has these nice, colorful illustrations. The characters don't look like real people, but it is a true story of a librarian from Iraq. It's called The Librarian of Basra, a true story from Iraq, and it's written by a woman named Jeanette Winter. Aliyah Muhammad Baker is the librarian of Basra, a port city in the sand-swept country of Iraq. Her library is a meeting place for all who love books. They discuss matters of the world and matters of the spirit. So that's in common with our library, right? Libraries anywhere in the world are for people who have a genuine love for books. Until now. Now, they only talk of war. Will planes with bombs fill the sky? Will bombs fall here? Will soldiers with guns fill the streets? Who among us will die? Will our families survive? What can we do? Aliyah worries that fires of war will destroy the books, which are more precious to her than mountains of gold. The books are in every language, new books, ancient books, even a biography of Muhammad that is 700 years old. She asks the governor for permission to remove them to a safe place, but he refuses. So Aliyah takes matters into her own hands, and secretly she brings books home every night, filling her car late after work. The whispers of war grow louder. Government offices are moved into the library, and soldiers with guns wait on the roof. Aliyah awaits and fears the worst. Then the rumors become reality. War reaches Basra. The city is lit with a firestorm of bombs and gunfire. Aliyah watches as library workers, government workers, and soldiers abandon the library. Only Aliyah is left to protect the books. She calls over the library wall to her friend Anis Muhammad, who owns a restaurant on the other side. Can you help me save the books? I can use these curtains to wrap them. Here are crates for my shop. Can you use these sacks? The books must be saved. All through the night, Aliyah, Anis, his brothers and shopkeepers and neighbors take the books from the library, pass them over the 7-foot wall, and hide them in Anis's restaurant. I want you to think, if I wanted to save the books here in our library, I wouldn't have to sneak them out, right? If something was going on, maybe the roof was leaking, or maybe there was something in the building that was dangerous that we had to get them out, I would be able to move them, right? But back then, those books in that library were owned by the government, and the government told her that she could not move them. So she was actually breaking the law. And we are lucky that we live in a country where if we break the law, we have a justice system that's supposed to work, right? It's supposed to go to trial and we go to court. But back then, or in other countries, I mean, they don't always have the same laws that we do. So she actually could have been punished by death if she had gotten caught stealing, because that's how they would have seen it, from the government. So she had to be super brave and super secretive. The books stay hidden as the war rages on. Then 9 days later, a fire burns the library to the ground. The next day, soldiers come to Anis's restaurant. Why do you have a gun? They ask. To protect my business, Anis replies. The soldiers leave without searching inside. They do not know that the whole of the library is in my restaurant, thinks Anis. At last, the beast of the war moves on. Aliyah knows that if the books are to be safe, they must be moved again while the city is quiet. So she hires a truck to bring all 30,000 books to her house and to the houses of her friends. In Aaliyah's house, books are everywhere, filling floors and cupboards and windows, leaving barely enough room for anything else. Aaliyah waits. She waits for the war to end. She waits and dreams of peace. She waits and dreams of a new library. But until then, the books are safe. The books are safe with the Librarian of Basra. The end. So this week for your library assignment, I want you to think, and you're going to use the second slide after our book click slide, and I want you to think, if you had to save one thing, if there's one thing in your life that is super important to you, what is the one thing that you would fight really hard and be really brave to save, even if there was danger that could come to you for doing it? That's what you're going to share with me on the second slide. I miss you. I can't wait until we are all in this beautiful library all together. I hope you're staying safe and healthy, and I can't wait to see you soon. Bye.